Yes.
Yeah. Good afternoon all.
Yes.
So we have seen that on the other day that the admin part, right? How you will download the exe file and then configure the workflow and all. In the today's session, we will see that actually the user how he will use it and then move the drawings for approvals and reviewers. So as a user, right, it is the same procedure that he has to go to the same URL and then user also has to download the exe file and then follow the instructions and then install it, and then once he got the DMS icon on his desktop, just you click on that, then up to here, right, for admin as well as the normal, either the thick client or thin client, the process is the same, downloading the exe file and installing and all. Only thing is that the admin login passwords and then user login passwords will be different, right? But both will be logging in through the same interface as you are seeing it. But the person who logs in through the admin, his role or his rights, right, the interfaces will be changing for him. Right. Similarly, that if a person log in as a thick client, he will have some facilities. As a thin client, he will have some facilities. So we are going to see all these things, but up to now it is the same for admin, thick client, and then thin client. So now once you log in, right? So if you people are having all, yes, please. So if you are having the system with you already, the username passwords are has been displayed over here. I request that you please carry out your practice simultaneously. So you log in as a user, enter this username and then the password, and then just you go through it. So here it has been explained that, right, the thick client and then the thin clients concept. The thick client is the one that who will be actually handling the drawing on the AutoCADs, who are preparing the drawings or modifying the drawings. So, and then the remaining all the people who will be only reviewing the drawing or approving the drawing, they are called the thin clients. So thick client and then thin client. The moment you log in, you will be able to identify visibly, right, whether he has logged in as a thick client or thin client just by the interface page itself, right? On the top left corner, right, so that an yellow banner gets displayed, it tells that you are a thin client, right? If that yellow banner is not there, then it is a thick client, right? So that is one visible indication. Now the moment you log in, right, whether you are logged in as an admin or whether you logged in as a thick client or thin client, this is the interface page you are going to see. Right, this is the default page for all the three people. Now for the sake of explanation, I have divided this page into the four parts, right? So I have marked it to 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I will go through the each one, right? So I will explain the first, the part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4, all the tabs, what they do, we will discuss it. You go to the tab 1, which has been highlighted, right? You will be having that too. These are the things, right? The file, tools, help, home and all, right? So see that what is the meaning of each and then what each will do. The file is just for the sake of a logout purpose. Simultaneously, you will have on the right bottom corner also the logout button. Through either of these things, you can log out from the application. Once you have come. Yes, please. I request that you kindly keep your mics on mute, so that it will not disturb others. So the logout can be done either from the file as well as at the right bottom corner also you will find this button. So once you complete your work, you log out. And then the next tab is the tools, right? We have seen extensively that what are the each tab will do in the tools in the admin module. So the only difference is that when you have logged in as an admin, and then you go through the tools and then administration, all the tabs what you are seeing, right, is the user management group, all the tabs will be active. Now you are using, you are logging in only as a user, not as an admin, then you will have only this legacy upload and then MIS. Only these two tabs will be active for you. Remaining all the tabs will be in the deactivated state because those are not required for the user. User will not manage, create the users, modify the users, or create the group or workflow configuration. Or either of these things the users will not do. So, and so through the tools that one can do the legacy upload and then MIS reports can be seen, right? Through the legacy upload, we have seen that, right? As a user that I am having the 50 drawings which are already prepared and then available with me, right? As of now, manually I am doing the work. So I want to upload all those drawings to my server, like our e-office digitization of the old files. By selecting this legacy upload, right, you can do the batch upload of all the files, right? You go here and then keep selecting the file after file, file after file, and then upload all these things in one go, right? So that is the legacy upload. And then one more is called the MIS reports, right? So yesterday also we have seen that what are the various kinds of the MIS reports that we generated. So this is the screen, the moment you click on that MIS reports, right? There is a very extensive search criteria available here, right? So MIS reports can be generated by the railway wise, division wise, department wise, right? And then the duration also from time to two time you select. And then if you click on, then the corresponding to that search criteria, you will get all the drawings displayed over here, right? And then if you select a particular drawing and then click on that, then corresponding to that drawing, what are the comments recorded inside the drawing will get displayed on the right top corner box, right? So this is where that I am moving my cursor over here. So in this box, right, for example, I have selected this particular drawing and then if you click on that, in this box, all the comments that were recorded inside the drawing will get displayed over here. Comments recorded inside the drawing. And then you will see one more box here. This is also a comments only, but these are the comments not recorded inside the drawing, but the comments were recorded and then sent to the top official or the bottom one for necessary action. So this is there is a difference between the comments which are recorded inside the drawing and then the comments which has been associated with the drawing. So that should be clear. And then the bottommost portion that you will see that a colorful bar, right? So which tells that this drawing, right, in each stage, how much duration has taken place, right? Work in progress stage, as well as the review one, review two, or approval one, how many times that it moved to and fro. So all these things. So this is the MIS reports are concerned. And then this is the bar, it will show that to all the drawings, right? So pertaining to the entire zone or the entire division, right? And then each drawing, just a graphical representation. And then there is an extensive help has been built in the application itself, right? So if you click on this help, right? So you will get so all the manuals and then the to other associated informations available. Are available so people can use this help, right, at any point of time if they get stuck up using the application. And then update, right, so if you are facing any persistent problem with the application, right, one simple thing one needs to do is that just you go there and then you update, right, you refresh your software. Then if any missing packages are there, it will fill the gaps and then your application will work normal again. And then you come to this file store, right? So this is where that you will be creating the folders, right? I am a new user to the EDAS application, right? In a particular division. The moment I log in this screen, so the first thing I will do is that I will create a folder. For example, if I belong to a New Delhi Railway Station, New Delhi Division, Engineering Department, I am the draftsman of that. I logged in as a thick client. The first thing I will do is that I will go to this file store and then I will create a folder, right, NLD division, right, engineering, right. So that is the folder. Henceforth, that whatever the works I will do, all those things I will store there, right. So within the folder, right, this is how you create the folder. Once you create the folder, you can create the any subfolders, right? So within the New Delhi Division Engineering Department, you can organize that the project wise, right? So folder, subfolder, and then within that particular folder, this is the ESP, right? This is the SIP. So all those things can be organized through this file store. And then the first box is now done. Now we are coming to the second box of the default screen, right? The second portion of the default screen. So second portion, you will see these things, right? So the check-in, refresh, search, and then other things. We will go through the each one now. So the first thing you will see here is the check-in, right? So the check-in means that uploading the drawing, right? So I am the draftsman. I have prepared my ESP or the SIP or the building layout plan on my CAD, right? So once I have done that job, right? So before sending for review or approval, I need to upload into the server and then convert into a PDF. Then only I will be able to send electronically to the reviewer the approvals. So for that, I will do, right? So as I explained earlier that I have already created a folder, right? So this is the folder for me, right? This is an RCIL, right? Within the RCIL, right? So now I prepared one drawing on my CAD and then I am processing it, right? So first you select the folder in which you want to upload this drawing, right? So this drawing I want to upload into my RCIL folder. I am the draftsman belong to the RCIL. So I have selected this RCIL and then you click on this check-in button, right? So you have seen that, right? So select the folder and then click on this check-in. Then you will get this dialog box, right? Enter all the details, right? So which railway, which division, what is the name of the project, right? What is the drawing type, whether it is an SIP or the ESP or a layout or whatever it is, right? And then we enter the notes, right? So if any comments or something, right, pertaining to the drawing, you want to say that this is an initial layout prepared or the phase one or phase two, whatever it is, enter the comments and then click on this add file. Then this file will get stored in our RCIL server, right? So through the check-in you are sending. Now the drawing is the property of the server, right? So nobody can delete it, right? Till now that the drawing was lying only on your desktop, right? You have prepared and then it is there, right? So now once you have uploaded it, it is the property of that server, right? So nobody can delete that, right? So we'll see that if any modifications needs to be done, how, but nobody can delete like our e-office, right? Once a document has been available on your desktop, it is your property. Once you have diarized it and then submitted it, now it is the property of the e-office, right? It is no more, nobody can alter it, nobody can delete it, right? So like that, this drawing, once it is uploaded, so that is a permanent record. So you send that. Once you have uploaded and then you click on the refresh button, right? So you have seen that, right? So there is a check-in, right? You have checked in now. I have uploaded the check-in means upload here, right? You have uploaded the drawing. After that, you click on this refresh button. Then your default screen will get refreshed and then the document just now you have uploaded will be visible on this grid marked part 2 of the default screen, right? So you will see all the details, right? So what are the details of this drawing that you will see? These are the details that will be appearing, right? The moment you click on this refresh button, your file will get appear on this default screen, right? And then you will see that what is the name of that file, version, right? You have uploaded the document initially. First time I prepared the drawing, and then I have uploaded it. I have checked in. The version is 0, right? I have uploaded, and then after uploading, that by evening something has come to my mind. I thought that anyway, that station name I have misspelled, right? I need to have a correction. Then what you can do is that again you need to check out the drawing. Check out the drawing means you download the drawing from the server, right? The moment you have downloaded the drawing, and then you make a necessary correction, and then you again you need to check in. The moment you have done the check-in this time, automatically here in this column, the version will get updated as the version 1 now. Right? So how many number of times you make a modification to the drawing, right? Every time you make a modification of anything, right? Putting a dot, removing a dot, or anything you do it, the version will get changed. Right? And then the old versions also gets stored. Right, just to have a reference that by version 1 to version 2, what modifications I have done. Then who has done, when it was done, right? So all this information gets stored. So that is the benefit of that EDAS system, right? So everything gets electronically tracked and then recorded, right? And then checked out and then checked in by. So checked out and then checked in, right? So this is the details you will see here. Checked out and then checked in. Latest, right? Who has checked out the drawing and then latest who has checked in the drawing, that details will get displayed over here, right? And then the state, as I explained to you, a drawing can be only in one of the three possible states, right? Only three states are possible in the EDAS. One stage is that the drawing is still under the preparation stage, that is the WIP state. The second state is that the drawing is under the reviewers, right? That is a review stage. The third state possible is that approvals state, right? Only three states are possible, and then this column, right, this state indicates that in which state this drawing is there right now, right? Right now, whether it is in the WIP state or the review state or the approval state. And then one more column is there, that is called the alteration. There is a difference between the version as well as the alteration, right? The version means that the drawing I prepared, I have uploaded, I thought that there is some correction needed, I have downloaded, and then again I made a modification, and then like that to and fro it keeps moving. I sent to the reviewer, reviewer suggested some modifications, again it comes back to me, I will incorporate the modification. Every time I do something on the AutoCAD, my drawing, that version changes, right? Whereas alteration is an altogether a different story. Like that you want to construct a building, you prepare the things, you send to the reviewer, he suggested, and then it comes back and all, right? So finally you got approved. And then you have constructed a building, right? Now that process is completed. Now after 5 years, somebody thought that why don't we construct one more floor or why don't we make modification in this room, right? At that point of time, whenever you are modifying the approved drawing, right? The drawing which has been approved when you are modifying it, then your alteration comes into the picture, right? Then it will mark in your drawing automatically that alteration 1, after that alteration 2, like that. So there is a difference between what is a version as well as the what is alteration. That should be clear. Any comments, right? So while you are uploading the drawing, right, you want to write any comments, then that will get reflected over here. And then the notes, anything that you want to attach along with the drawing, that also will get. Then the file details. The file details is nothing but this particular drawing is stored where, right, in which folder it is there, that details will get reflected. So this is the story of the second grid of the default page. So once you have selected the folder and then you have checked in the drawing by giving the details, right, and then you click on the refresh button, then all these details as I discussed just now will get appeared on the second grid. And then there is one more facility available, that is called the attach files, right? So it is not sufficient for you to send only the drawing to the reviewer or the approver, right? The reviewer may demand the more supported documents, right? Maybe the estimate copy or preliminary drawing, right? So whatever the things, right? So there is a facility available that is called the attach files, right? So you click on this button and then you can attach any Word document, Excel document, or the JPG files, or whatever the things which supports the drawing, and then we attach it. So wherever this drawing is going, right, either for review or the approval, all these attachments also will go along with the drawing. So it has those facilities. Now there is a search facility available in the same second grid, right? So you can search the drawing by file name or the project name or the unit name, right? So exhaustive check facilities, search facilities available. So that also can be used. Now we will come to the third part of the default panel, right? So this is the third part. You will see here there are the certain things which are highlighted in yellow as well as certain things highlighted in the green. So the moment you log in, on the default page, right, anything which is marked in the yellow or green will immediately attract your attention. The yellow indicates that by you are, for example, the yellow indicated and then markup and commenting four, it tells that the four drawings has been marked pending with you, which requires your commenting and then review. And then if anything is there on the green highlighted, it tells that so this many number of files has been marked or pending with you for your approval. So this is to attract the immediate attention, right? So of the user the moment he logs in. And at the bottom of this, bottom part of this third grid, right, it tells that, right, if you click on this markers and markup and comments, right, so then all the details pertaining to the pending documents, those things will get displayed over here. So now we'll move to the fourth part of our grid, right, of the default page, right. In the fourth part, you will see a lot of things. You see here, there's history, attachments, license details, workflow log, right? So these things are very helpful, right? So far we have seen only that the drawing has been uploaded and then the drawing, anything is there that you will get reminders. But particular things, right? The details pertaining to the drawing, right? Like his history and all will be available in the fourth grid. Right, the history, the moment, right, so you click on that, right, so you will get that, the entire history of the drawing, right, so when the drawing got originated, right, so where the drawing is right now, all the details will be visible here. So just 1 minute. So, and then the second tab is that attachments, right? So, any attachments that you have sent along with the drawing, so those things also will be visible, right? Someone has, right, that some draftsman has sent, prepared and then send it to you. And then you have logged in as a user, right? The moment you click on the drawing, you will know that what are the attachments that has come so that you can view them and then you can take an appropriate decision, right? So, that is important. And then the third one is that the license details. So this is not for the user purview, right? It is for the admin. So we will skip over this, right? Otherwise, just it will tell that, right? So pertaining to that, when the license was procured and then up to where that validity will be there, etc. So that's not much an important thing now. And then the workflow, right? So you will see here, right, so that entire workflow log, right, so from where to where this drawing has moved, right, so from the time that it was initiated, right, so entire details will be available of that particular drawing the moment you see the workflow log. Markup and comments, right, markup and comments, this drawing was sent to four people. Right, so all the four people, whether they have approved or not, or it is pending with them, will be able to be seen here. Right, so similarly, the approved documents. For example, this document was approved, right, when it was approved, right, so by whom, so all those things will get come over here. Then one more thing is there, that the summary of the review and comments, right? The summary, that means it is in Excel sheet, right? So you will see that all the comments that has been received against the drawing, right? So all those things will be able to be seen in one go. And then the last one is called the pending, right? So many works are pending, right? So we have sent the drawing to four people. Three people have approved, one has not approved, right? So what are all the things pending against the drawing? Those details also can be seen over here. So now that the default page, right? So what are the all the items that are there we have seen, right? The moment you log in, right? This is the default screen, right? So I think we have covered everything, right? There is nothing has been left. So as a user, as a trainer, I request all of you that you please log in and then you play around, right? And then upload some drawings, right? So and then try to form groups and then practice the things, right? Now we will see that how these facilities will be used, right? So these are all the, so far we have discussed only that what are all the things available there as a part of the software. Now we'll see that how those things are to be used, right? And then who has to use it. As I explained to you, right? So in the entire EDAS, there are only three kind of players are there. Of course, four, right? Including the admin. Right. So admin part you leave it, and the actual e-office usage rests with three players. One is that the WIP, right? That is called the work in progress, right? The full form. This is a standard language used by the this AutoCAD, this drawing worlds, not for us, right? So for us, it is a chief draftsman or the draftsman or the junior draftsman or the SSC drawings, we call it. So, in a nutshell, the WIP means the pupil that who actually use the AutoCAD, right? Who prepare the drawings, who handles the drawings, right? So, this is the one group of the people, right? We'll call that group as the WIP. The second type of the group of the people who use this is called the reviewers, right? This is the maybe the senior supervisors and then junior level officers. So when these drawings are prepared by the WIP and then sent to them, so they will go through the drawing, they review it, and then they will offer the comments, suggestions, etc. So the second group is the reviewers. Then the third group is the approvers, right? So maybe the division level, senior DST, senior DN, DRM, and at the zonal level, HODs or PHODs or some drawings maybe by the GM, right? Or CAO, we can say. So these are the three types of the groups of the people, right? The WIP, reviewers, and then approvers. So we will see now that to each of these groups, how they can use effectively this EDAS platform. Now we'll see that the user module at the rate of WIP, right? So how he will use it and then for what purpose he will use it. Okay. So as we have seen that the draftsman, right, the WIP, they prepare the drawing on the AutoCAD on their standard machines. And then they, as we I explained earlier that, so you select the particular folder and then you upload the drawing to that folder by selecting the check-in process. Once the drawing was checked in, now the next step, what he has to do is that he has to send this drawing to the concerned pupil. Maybe he is sending for the comments, if the drawing warrants comments or review, or maybe he is sending directly for approval if it is a minor drawing or etc., some kind of a thing. But it is the WIP who decides that what action needs to be done on that particular drawing, right? So whether for that he needs to select, right? So you click on this particular drawing, right? This is the drawing. This is the, you see that in the blue color. This is the particular file just now I have checked in. I click on that particular file. Right, so which I need to process now, and then right click on it, and then you select that, right, apply workflow definition, right. So now that this every drawing is unique, you know that, right? This particular drawing I have prepared, this drawing may be reviewed by some ABC officers and then approved by some XYZ. And another set of the drawing I prepared, which may be required to be reviewed by some P and Q and then approved by some Z. So to whom I have to send this drawing, right? So that workflow needs to be defined by me, who has uploaded the drawing. So that is the WIP. So that process is called this workflow definition and all, right? So select the particular drawing, right click on that, click on this workflow definition, right? So when the moment you click on this workflow definition, right? So you have created, you remember that in the part one admin training, right? So we have created the different types of the workflows, right? Workflow creation, we have discussed it, right? For example, if I am belong to the RCIL and then I am the draftsman of the RCIL, right? So I have given a name for my workflow as RCIL workflow, right? If I belong to a senior DST office of the New Delhi division, I could have created, right? So as a New Delhi division SNT department workflow, right? So that part has been done as part of the admin settings itself, right? So now your job here is that to select that, right? So select that, right? Select the particular drawing and then click on this workflow definition and then you apply that, right? So I have selected here RCIL workflow, right? I have selected RCIL workflow, right? This is the through this particular workflow, this drawing should go, right? Maybe this drawing I am sending to an RVNL instead of, right? So then in that case, I will create a different workflow for that. Right, so select that particular workflow which has to be pre-programmed as part one of that what we have discussed by the admin. Right, you select that and then you again right click on that drawing and then click on this change state. Right, so far as I explained to you, the drawing can be there at any point of time in only one of the three states that is possible. As the WIP state, review state, or approval state. So right now it is there only in the WIP state because I prepared and then I uploaded and all, right? So no two states are not there. Now I want to send this drawing to the review, right? For that I need to change the state, right? Now WIP state to review state. Or if I want to send directly to the approval, then also that I can do that, right? For that also the change state and then you select that to which state you want to send it. So click on this change state and then you see here you are getting this, right? This highlighted box here. I have already defined that, right? Within that workflow, what are the things possible, right? Within that workflow, whether I can send it for review or approval or review one, review two, whatever I defined it. Here you see that I have created within that workflow RCIL approval, RCIL review one, right, two RVNL. These are the three kinds of the states I have defined to which I can send this drawing. So I have selected RCIL approval. The moment you click on that, you will find a drop down box, a dialog box appears in which all the approvers, right? So you have grouped it. You remember that you have created three types of the groups as part of the admin: WIP group, approval group, reviewers group. When you want to confirm that, CO group or Mumbai. Hello.
Yeah.
So, are you able to recall that what we have discussed in the last session that we have created these three groups?
Yes.
So, the group creation was done there, right? So, whatever the group you have created, right? In the previous slide, I have selected the RCIL approval. The moment approval I have selected, all the people who has I have added in the RCIL approval group will appear in this window. Right? So let me say that in the RCIL itself, I have kept that the drawings can be approved by all directors, CMD, EDs in the CO. I created the group. Already the group was created as part of that group creation. Now that entire group will be visible here. Within that group, whether maybe I want to send the approval of only the DNPM, I will select only him, right? Or I want that this drawing should be approved by 3-4 directors, I can select. So this is the group that you need to select, right? Within that approval group, whom you want to send it. Whereas the group formation was done prior to that, as part of the admin part, okay? So you need to select that, right? Who has to approve the drawings? Or who has to review the drawings otherwise. Once that was done, then you will get to one more dialog box, right? This dialog box is like that automation of the signatory columns in the drawing, right? So within the drawing itself, whose signatures you want to appear, right? So this EDAS software automatically creates the table for you and then it embeds their designation and then the DSC signatures, etc., everything based on this step. Right? Whose reviews required or whose approvals required needs to be selected in the previous step. Right? Based on that, the previous step, whether it is an approval group, then you select the people who has to approve from that approval group. Or if you select that, I am sending it for review, then you select the people who has to review it. Right? That is the second part. The third part is that whose signatures should be appearing on the drawing. Right? So that is a third part of that. Just you tick mark that and then you submit it. Right? Automatically, all these people, automatically that table, right? For example, if it is a 3 people, then the 3 row table will get created. If it is a 5 people signature required, 5 people row table will get created. Their designations will come automatically there. The moment they sign using the DSC, their signatures also, DSC signatures also appear. So this is the significance of this, the third step, right? So you select that people whose signature should be appearing on the drawing and then you submit it. Right? So once you have done that, right, the confirmation box will be there. Just you confirm that everything is okay. Right? I request that you please keep your mic in off mode so it will not disturb others. So once you have selected that signatories, you finalize that, then you will get a confirmation message. Just you follow the instructions on the screen, then the drawing, right, the original AutoCAD drawing will appear to you on the screen, right? So, and again, follow the on-screen instructions, then the table will get automatically popped up with the details, right? So, what you have selected, whose signatures required you have selected in the previous steps, right? The table will get automatically gets created with their designations and all. Now, next step is that you need to select within the drawing that where that signatory box needs to be appeared, right? You select, for example, if you select that, the signature box should appear in this portion. You just click on that, the entire table will get embedded here. Or you select that signature box should appear here. You select, right? So select the location where that entire signatory box will get inserted. Once that part has been done, the next step is that this drawing needs to get converted into the PDF. Right? So let me say that you have created an entire yard plan, right? But you want to send for the review purpose only a particular portion of that yard, not that entire drawing, right? So this what you are seeing is, let me say that the entire drawing you are seeing over here, but you want to send only the portion of this drawing, only this portion of this drawing you want to send it for review, then also it is possible. Right. So whatever the portion of the drawing you want to send, you select the two points, two diagonally opposite points on this screen, right, what you are seeing it, then that particular portion will get cropped up and then gets converted into PDF automatically. For example, on this particular drawing, I selected this one point, and then I selected this another point, then this entire drawing will get converted into PDF. For example, I have selected one point this, and then second point I have selected this, only this portion will get converted into PDF. Right? So this is how that you can select, right? Not only the entire drawing can be converted into the PDF just by selecting the two end points in the diagonal opposite points. Then entire drawing gets converted into PDF, or you want to select a particular portion of that drawing, that is also possible. Right? So once that has been done, then that particular drawing gets converted into a PDF, right? And then that PDF will get pushed for review or the approval, right? With that closes the particular state of the WIP. So far the drawing is in the WIP state, right? So I will review it once more, just in a quick manner. So I am a WIP. Right, so I have logged in, and then as I told you that there is a AutoCAD drawing prepared and then available in my system. I checked in the drawing and then I have done the attachments, and then I have refreshed, then this entire drawing details available here, right click on that, and then apply the workflow definition and then select that which workflow that through which this drawing should be pushed out. Right, I have selected that. And then now right now it is there in the WIP state. Now I want to send it for review. I will click on this change state, and then I will select that the RCIL review because I want to send it there. Right? The moment you select that, you will get the pop-up windows. One pop-up window is that within that review group, whether you want to send to all the people for review or one person for the review or some XYZ people within that group, you select that. Then only to those people it will go for the review. That is one part. The moment you've done that, you will get one more pop-up screen. In that, it will tell, right? So whose signatures you want to appear within the drawing, right? Within the drawing, the table will get created automatically. And then once the user signs, so even the DSC also appears there, right? This is the automation, right? So once you submit that, and then follow the on-screen instructions, then the drawing will appear on the AutoCAD, right, with the table that has been created as per the details that you have selected. Then within the drawing, you just select a particular portion where you want to put this table, and then click on that, the table will get fixed in the drawing, right. So, and then now it is done. Now that now it has to be closed, right? Now everything is done. The table created, selected the people, etc., etc., etc. Now this drawing needs to be just pushed out. That pushed out is the last step, is nothing but within this PDF, right? So which portion of this drawing you want to send it for review or the approval, right? The entire drawing you want to send, you select this one point. And then another point, diagonally opposite ends of this complete drawing, then this entire drawing will go. Or you want to send only a portion of the drawing, you select one point and another point, only that particular portion will go. Right? The moment you have done this and then submit it, now the drawing has gone from the WIP state to the reviewer state. Now the drawing is within the purview of the reviewer. It is no more in the work in progress. Now you'll see that what the reviewer will do, right? So as I explained to you, right? So anyone, right? You have just logged in. The moment you have logged in on the third grid of the default screen, immediately you will see a yellow banner, right? The yellow banner immediately attracts your attention. It tells that there are four drawings are pending for your review, right? So just you click on that banner. Right. So, for example, three drawings are pending with you, then all the three drawings details will appear over here. Or five drawings are there, so all those things will come over there. Right. And then you select that particular drawing. Right. So, for example, five drawings has come to you. Right. So, you have to work one after one. Right. You select that one particular drawing and then click on that. Then you will get the pop-up window like this. Right. You select that markup and comments. Right, the moment you select the markup and comments, you will get the drawing opened in the PDF, and then you see here there is a portion highlighted with the tools. You study the drawing, drawing was opened up in the PDF, you study the drawing, once you studied the drawing, click on the tools, and then you want to offer the comments against the drawing, you select this tab, and then you record your comments. Right. So whatever the comments that you want to record, right? Again, recording the comments, a lot of tools has been made available, right? You want to record it as a dialogue box or some text or whatever the fashion, you choose the appropriate tool and then record your comments, right? So whatever the comments that you have recorded, right? So whatever the comments that you have recorded using this tool will get recorded within the drawing itself, right? So whatever you write will appear in the drawing, in the drawing. That is very important. So once you have done that, then you need to just to send it back, right? The send it back procedure is nothing but it will get automatically popped up, right? So whether you want to save this comments that you have recorded or not, it is a kind of a reminder to you, right? Before just blindly submitting it, once you have recorded the comments, right? So the moment you say that, okay, you go ahead, right? Then it will replaces the original drawing, right, with the drawing with your comments, right? So the same workplace, right? Your original drawing also lies in this same folder, workspace, right? So this is the default folder of the EDAS documents. So the old drawings will get replaced by the drawing with your comments recorded on it. Right. The moment you have done that, then one more pop-up window appears, right? So as I explained to you earlier, there are the two types of comments. One is that the comments which will get embedded within the drawing itself. The second type of comments are the things which will get associated with the drawings, right? Just for communication purpose, you can say. Right. The first one you have seen that, right? The comments which you have recorded using this tool are the comments which get embedded within the drawing, right? So the moment you close that, second type of the window pops up. We hear that you can write again a comments, right? Any additional comments you want to communicate for the approver or the WIP, you can write here, and then you click on this verify signature, right? So for a reviewer, so this is an optional facility, verify signature. Right. So for the approvers, it is a must. Right. So just you click on this submit button, then the job of the reviewer has been done. Right. So I will just summarize it again. As a reviewer, you have logged in. The moment you have logged in, the banner flag is flashing. It immediately attracts your attention. It tells that this many drawings are pending for you for your review. Then you click on that. Then you will see the list of that. And then select the particular one drawing and then right click it. And then select the markup and comments. And then the drawing will get popped up in the PDF. You study the drawing and then you want to offer some comments. Then you select the tools. And then you write the comments that whatever you want to write, right? And then you choose the option to save. Then your comments will get saved into the drawing. And then one more type of the pop-up window comes. This you want to send any additional comments, right? So then you record it there and then submit it. Then the reviewer job is done now. Once you have signed it, right. So once you have signed it, then that your signature will get updated in the server itself, and then the WIP can be able to see that. Right. So I have sent this drawing to the four people for the review. Right. So three people have given their comments. One person is not yet given. Right. Because you will be able to see it. right? You will be able to see that, right? So you see that in the earlier column we have seen that. Here you see that markup and comments, right? You have selected a drawing and then you click on this markup and comments. It will tell that, you see, I have marked this drawing to these 5 people. Out of that, the 4 people have responded, and then one has not responded, one has given comments, 3 people have not given. All these things you will be able to see here, right? So markup and comments, and then the pending works, right? So the WIP knows it, right? Whatever the actions the reviewers has done, and then if it is more than the desired time it is pending with the reviewer, WIP can go and then give him a gentle reminder. So the reviewer portion has been done. Reviewer has received a drawing, he has studied the drawing, and then he has recorded his comments, and then he has sent it back. The job is done. Now all reviewers has completed their reviews, and then it has the drawing again came back to the WIP. Now the WIP has seen all the comments recorded by all the reviewers, and then he has carried out all the modifications in the drawing. Right. Once he has done all the modifications on the drawing as per the reviewer's comments, next step is that he has to send that drawing to the approver. Right. So here the approver role will be again the same. Right. Like the reviewer and approver, there is not much a difference. So approver also just logs in. Like the reviewer, the moment he logs in, the only difference is that if you are an approver, you will get the, in the default screen, you will get the green banner, right? So instead of the yellow banner, you will get the green banner, right? So the moment he logs in, he will look at the green banner, it is flashing, he knows that there are the some files which has come to me for my approval. You click on that and then follow the same steps, right? So select the drawing and then right click and then markup and comments. The moment the approver select the markup and comments, so then he will go into the tools. The moment he click on the tools, and then he will select that, right, the DSC signature, right? So click on this certificates, then you see here like our e-office project, right, the digitally sign option you choose, and then you follow the instructions, right? So you put your DSC dongle, and then you select the appropriate user, then your signature will get embedded within the drawing. You see here this table was created automatically, like in the second step, right? In the WIP stage itself, when the drawing was before converted to PDF itself, the table was created, my designation also appeared. Now the moment I signed it, my signature also appears, and then everything gets instantaneously gets recorded and updated in our server itself. Whether I write a comment, whether I sign it, whatever you do it, right, it will get reflected in the server, right? So I have signed that, right? Now I have approved it. But not only that, I have approved it, while approving, I want to record some comments. That is also quite possible. While approving, you will be approving subject to some conditions, etc. This is quite normal in the railway environment, or maybe outside. So I have approved the drawing, but subject to some conditions, right? So to communicate the conditions, the moment you digitally sign it, automatically a window gets popped up. This is the window, right? The moment you see that, here that you can write your comments, right? So whatever comments you want to write, you write it, right? And then you click on this verify signature. This is a must. This is a final chance for the approver to review his actions, right? So once you have signed, digitally signed, you have put your dongle and all, and then this window comes, you record your comments, and then finally you think that, okay, now it is final, and then I want to push it off. Just to click on this verify signature, then your signature will get verified, dialog box appears, then you click on the submit, then the job is done. So that your approval gets recorded in the original drawing. So this is the entire workflow of this E dash drawings are concerned. So the two slides are there prior to this, right? How the DSC registration needs to be done, which is more similar to our e-office thing, right? So you follow that instructions and then the users can register their digital certificate in one go, right? So this is the entire process through which this e-DAS application runs. Now we are open for discussions. So if anyone is having any doubts or anything, we can talk now for some time.
Yes, sir, one question, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, if the drawing is initiated by the WIP member.
Yeah.
And the drawing is finally going to check in. Mm-hmm. So it will go automatically for PDF version, or we have to convert in PDF?
No, you need not convert anything. It is everything is the EDAS only doing it, but that process needs to be followed, right? So first thing is that your drawing will go into the server. It is not going anywhere. At that stage, it is not converted.
Okay.
Right? So you, right? The when it will get, conversion is automatic only. You are not doing anything. But when it will get converted, that is the point. When I have right. checked, you know, it goes to the server and then store. So at that time, it is not converted. Once I have uploaded it, then I want to send it to particular pupil. Then you have seen that. The first step is that I have to first select that. This drawing needs to be put into which workflow? Select the workflow. Then within that workflow, you are having the, again, the two roles are there, right? So one is that approval role, review role, or review to whatever you have defined it. Within that workflow, you select that particular approval. For example, you want to send this drawing for approval. Then the approval group members are visible there. You select that group members. And then you will have one more dialog box that whose signature should appear on the table, right? Then the table will get inserted. After the table is getting inserted, and then you select that which portion of the drawing you want to send it for review or approval, at that point, that particular portion will get converted into the PDF.
Yeah, right.
Correct, no? The entire right, drawing you are sending or part you are sending, you have not yet decided at the time of check-in, right? So you are deciding it at the last stage of the WIP process. The moment you select, by selecting the two points on that drawing, that particular thing is getting converted into the PDF and then it goes. There is nothing to send it out.
Got it, sir. Thank you, sir. And yeah. One more question is, sir.
Yeah.
That group creation for the reviewer or the approver, by the designation basis only, or it will be can be created by name also?
No, it is by designation. Because in your railways or maybe in any other organization, any signatures appear, it always appears by designation. It is not by name, right? The DRM Walter, they will write, or the Senior DST New Delhi, right? They will not write Ramesh Babu, Senior DST New Delhi. No. It is by designation.
And third one, sir, that yellow highlight is only for this one, a reviewer.
The yellow highlight is for the any drawings are pending for with review, and then the green is for any drawings pending for approval. Right?
Right. So thank you, sir. It is clear.
For example, you are the person. For drawings, you may be the reviewer. For some drawings, you may be the approver also. That is possible, no? For example, let me say that you are in AST, right? So some small drawings are there, which will come for you for approval. For example, some SIP or something, you will only acting as a review. Correct? Your role is changing as per the type of the drawing also. That means you may get the yellow banner as well as the green banner, same user. Right? So only thing, any drawing which is marked to you for review, it will be on the yellow banner. If any drawing is marked to you for approval, and the green banner.
Sir, on kar do. One small question, sir.
Yes.
If a drawing is having more than one approver, let's suppose it is having n number of approvals.
Correct.
First, X number of approvers have approved it. They have digitally signed it.
Yes.
And now, in between process, one of the approvers gives some PDF comment.
Yes.
That needs to be incorporated in the this.
Yes. So I have created the drawing. I am a WIP. I have sent for the approval of the four people.
Yes, sir.
Right. The table was created of the four people, and then it gone simultaneously to all four people. All four people logged in at different times and all. One person has opened it, seen the PDF. Everything is okay. He signed and then given comments, etc. Right. But the fourth person, even he is having some reservation, so there is nothing which is stopping him from signing. He signs it and then he is writing his comments.
Sir,
see, we are rejecting the drawing also. Rejection also will be done under signature.
Yeah, here the question is that since like a ESP, ESP requires the approval of 8 to 10 agencies.
Correct.
Okay. And one agency already been approved it. Three agency already were approved it. Fourth agency read some query that he is not agree with the with drawing. He wants some changes in the drawings.
Correct.
And he is accordingly comment over that one. Correct. Then again back to the WIP.
Correct.
WIP make a necessary correction over the drawing as per the recommendation of the approving authorities.
Correct.
The, those agency already been approved on that time, three agencies. Now their comment again required because they have been approved in on the initial basis drawings.
And you see that
any modification over the their changes.
I agree with you, but here it is a protocol that your organization want to follow it. See, it is a drawing. These four people approved. One person has suggested a modification. Once you have done any modification, right? You don't know that what will be the reservations of the remaining four people.
Yeah, that is absolutely right. Like suppose in division drawing. Made by the construction and ESP plans and coming for the approval of the division at the different stages.
Correct.
Like senior ST, senior in coordination, senior DOM, senior DE, DRD, like that.
Correct.
Now, senior DST has been approved, it already been approved.
Correct.
Senior DOM make some point, no, I want to add again one point over that one area.
Correct.
Okay, so ESP is required to be modified accordingly.
Yes, yes.
And then again the signature of the senior DST is again required over the drawing.
Required. Required.
That's a basic fundamental.
Required.
Okay.
Because he doesn't know, no, see, he has approved it, the drawing which was there. Now after modification, you don't know.
Yeah, he may not be agree, he makes some reservation over that one, whatever the suggestion by the other people.
Correct. 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 So here the thing is that it goes parallelly to all five people. Parallelly to all five people, four people approved, one person has given the comments and then was saying that I am not agreeing with this or this modification needs to be done. And then it comes back to the WIP. WIP again will go through all the comments and all, and then he will do the modifications accordingly and then again he will push it. But every time you do a modification, right, then it needs to be looked by the all other people. Before
means about the approval given by the initial in phase, that is basically null and void. If
natural,
the any higher official giving the recommendation to modify the plan.
Correct, correct. Yeah, any modifications you do on the drawing, my earlier approval doesn't stand.
Yes.
So again it goes.
Sir, one more doubt, sir.
Yes.
In review phase, if four reviewers are there,
correct,
and if whatever comments are given by first reviewer, It should be visible by all the next three reviewers, whoever is reviewing it next.
That facility is there, that's when you lock in any user, particular drawing you select it, you have seen that on the fourth grid, right? So any markup comments and all, right? Against that particular drawing, anybody has offered any comments, you will also be able to see it.
Even the PDF comments also, sir.
Everything moves in the PDF only.
Okay.
In the software, at the bottom if you click on that, you will be able to see all the comments recorded by the all the reviewers or all the approvers.
No, sir, my point is that let's suppose WIP, our draftsman is sending one file, one PDF. He has created an initial PDF. Reviewer 1 has given some comment in that PDF comments.
Yes.
So, whenever he is saving this, the file, whatever modification he has done will reflect to all other 3 or 4 reviewers.
No, right? Modification, he is not doing any modification. He is only writing his observations.
In PDF.
He is adding comments.
No, whether you do it in PDF or outside PDF, anything that you are doing, you are making only, you are not doing any modification. Modification, everything is in the purview of the WIP.
WIP.
He is just saying that any suggestion or the observation recommended by the any, reviewer will be seen to the other reviewer also.
He will not be able to see. See, it has went to all four people have seen it. This fellow has given 2 comments, this fellow has given 4 comments, etc, etc. Now it has come to WIP. WIP has made modifications. And then while again sending it back, then all the comments which has originally has come will be made available to all 4 people.
Yes, sir, yes.
X has suggested this, Y has suggested this, Z has suggested this.
Sir.
He may accept it or may not be accepted, some recommendation made by the reviewer and incorporated accordingly in the drawing.
That's what. So, when it is pushing the second time, all the comments offered by all the people will get reflected to everyone.
Yeah.
So, people will know that this modification is done because X has suggested this, Y has suggested this, Z has. People know that. Any other things?
And sir, while placing the signature box,
yeah,
we are first placing the signature box and then we are deciding what section of this drawing needs to be converted to PDF.
Correct.
What will happen if my signature box is outside the area I have selected?
The signature box has to not to do with the that particular one, right? So what you are sending is a drawing. You are not sending the signature box.
Correct.
He is not signing that signature, right?
Mm-hmm.
The software automatically captures and then he will put it in that particular grid against his designation, right? So, we are sending a portion of it. That is a very rare case. Normally, a drawing will be sent as it is. Just to, that is what additional facility is there that I highlighted it to you. Otherwise, just normally anybody will send the full drawing, right? But you want to highlight a particular portion of the drawing that also you can do, that's what I highlighted. Normally you will do that for the purpose of the reviews, not for the approvals, right? So you want that the reviewers to have a close look at a particular portion, then you will do that.
Hello.
Otherwise the entire drawing you are sending it. Any other things, please? Anyone? Would like to ask something, please. Lucknow. Deepusha batch. CEO Priyanka madam.
Yes, sir. We would like to first experiment with this module. Actually, when we were trying it, it is quite slow. So every time it is, we are not.
Yeah. It follows that FTP protocol. I have already suggested to them to revamp that.
Yeah.
But that is a parallel process, right?
Okay, sir.
So lot many people have given lot many suggestions. So okay. We communicated to them, and then next version when they release it,
yeah,
we will try to have a more smoother. Interface.
Yeah, but whatever we try to do, it takes time. A lot of time we have to refresh it and then only we can see further.
Yeah.
So we need some time to actually experiment with it so we can come up with our queries afterwards.
Yes. Yeah. A lot means not to. It is taking around 1 minute time, something like that. So, but people can work with that.
Okay,
so basically, sir. It was designed on the FTP protocol. Actually, it should work fast. But I told them that to revamp that complete module, make it available on the web-based application like our e-office, so yes, that it will reach more easily. But this is a working module. But this is a working module.
While uploading the file, sir, I had a question. While uploading the file, is it a mandatory thing to have it in a drawing format only, or we can attach it as a PDF also?
No. It is a AutoCAD. It has interface only. So because the uploading will be done only by the WIP.
Okay.
Right, only by the WIP, right? So the drawing must have had prepared on the AutoCAD. So this EDAS will be interfacing closely with the AutoCAD software.
Okay. Right? And any kind of logs would be available?
Yeah, all kinds of logs are there. Yes. Okay. All kinds of logs are there. We will be able to see it. Admin logs are there. User logs are there. So we'll be able to extract the information. So.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yes, madam. So, any other one have any doubts or any suggestions? Or should we call off?
Yeah, sir. We need some time to check it out so that we can revert back.
Yeah, please have that to just like this thing. But like our e-office, right? Initially, we have struggled for a little time. But now that I think everyone is extremely comfortable and then. Easy to handle.
Yeah.
So this one also, right? The one advantage of this particular EDAS module is that the average user education of the EDAS module is much higher than the e-office. Right? So the EDAS is handled primarily by the chief draftsmen and all. They are very, very well versed with the AutoCAD, computer working and all. So it is very easy. As well as the reviewers and approvers are seen, you have seen that their job just you log in and then you will see that yellow banner or the green banner, you click on that, right click, drawing will get opened, you study it and then give your comments and then close it. That's it. Alright, so there is nothing much that the user needs to do, right? So the implementation could be quite easy, right? And then the people also, normally I have seen that with the 20 years of this thing, the railway, the draftsman community is largely very sincere people, okay. Right, compared to other groups of the railway men. So it will be very easy to take the things, and then this is a working product. I have interacted with some 5-6 divisions, so they positively confirmed that they are using it.
Okay.
Right, so there might be much a problem, and then this video recording of the previous session I have shared, this session also I'll share it. So please, and sure. Then at any point of time, and then based on the inputs that you people will be giving to me, right? So we'll try to update the PDF and then try to create more detailed things, and then as and when it is done, we'll push it to our EDAS e-office group.
Sure. In this case, user group would be less as compared to the e-office group, which
much less, much lesser. So in a division. If you have 100, that is a very big number.
Yeah.
The journal headquarters, entire journal headquarters, if you have 150 people, it's a very big number. Not much. Very small community.
Okay.
So, someone is saying something. Yeah.
History.
Yes. Ravi, should we close off?
We need to get more hands-on to it and then we'll have better understanding of it.
Yeah. Please go through it, right? I have shown that the login username, password, exe file as well as admin username was made available to you. Please go through it and then play around that. And then keep some sample drawings with you and then you upload from here to there and all. And you see that. And then we can know.
User interface is not that user friendly as it is.
As I told that it is not a commercial product, right? Still they are under the development. It may get revamped. I have given all the suggestions to them. But the fact remains that it is a working product. So people are already using it. So that will let us take it forward. And then as and when the next version comes, it automatically is the thing.
Do we have the list of divisions using it?
Except NR and then NWR, remaining all zones has been implemented.
All zones and all divisions of the...
All zones and then all divisions.
Okay.
Check. So, this is the... So, NR and NWR, they are also will get implemented shortly.
Okay.
So, any other one want to have any doubts to be get clarified, or should we call off the session? Okay. Thank you very much. Thanks all.
Thank you, sir.
Sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you so
you
much.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, we'll get back. Bye. Thank you.
Yes, sir.